Welcome back. Today we're going to be using bound checking on parameters so that we work with a 2D array, making sure we don't go out of bounds and cause any problems to what we're working with. When we're talking about doing array manipulation or 2D array manipulation, especially in bounds of working with the picture project for the AP Photo Lab. As you can see right here, I'm inside my picture.java where all the work happens for all the methods we've been working with. And I have one called random change. And this random change method has four parameters that we're working with. It has a start row and start call that are both ints. And then it has a height and width that are also both ints. And remember, when we're talking about parameters, the order of the parameters matters in the fact of type, but not by name. Because when we're talking about them, the orders of the type is how we actually specify them. As with all of the 2D array picture algorithms we're working with, the first thing we're going to need to do is we need to make sure we get the pixels out of that as a 2D array of pixel objects. And so a pixel 2D array pixels is this.getPixels2D. So I can grab that, and that's how I'm going to validate the work we're doing, making sure that whatever we're doing inside this, say if this method is called randomly or by giving random values, it'll automatically make sure it works within the bounds of the picture we're working with. Then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to check to make sure that both the width and the height, the actual bounds we're talking about for specifying a random range of that picture, are valid. So if width is greater than or equal to pixels sub 0.length, or width is less than 0, I will re-randomly assign a value to that based on math.random times pixels sub 0.length, making sure my width is a random value. And I'm using random explicitly on this because normally we don't want to override a parameter that's supplied to a method. But because this method explicitly designed to have a random change to it, and if the bounds are not specified appropriately in advance, I want to make sure I give a still effect on that. And so I'm making sure I get a new valid value on top of that. So mass.random times pixels sub 0.length and assign that to an int of width. So I reassign that value. I do the same approach on height, checking though against pixels.length, because when we're talking about length, that's the number of rows that we have inside that 2D array, versus pixels sub 0.length is the width, the number of pixels going wide across the screen. And again, I check to make sure it's not less than 0. It should never be, but hey, just in case, we'll reassign that right there. Once I've taken care of the width and the height, I then want to take a look at the start and the row and the start column values, making sure they are also valid. And so I want to make sure that start col plus width is greater than equal to dot length, or start call is less than 0. So making sure if I add that width, it's going to be in there. So I want to make sure that if it is, then I say start call is going to be assigned math.random times pixels sub 0.length minus width. So no matter what, that width that I specify will automatically fit inside that. So I have a space that will automatically fit. Same thing on start row plus height. If it's greater than or equal to pixels.length or start row is less than 0, then I'll reassign a value based on that same bit of math, making sure that it'll fit within bounds going from top to bottom for my starting point. So I have a nice width and column chunk. So regardless of where that magic starting point is, that same specified width and height that I have specified for it will fit within the picture. Then, of course, I have my nested for loop that I used to do the traversal over that 2D array. Again, I start my row off at start row because that's what I'm starting with. When I'm doing my test, however, I have to make sure that row is less than height plus start row. Now, I had a little logic when I first did this because I'm like, oh, I forgot to do the add on that because, oh, is row less than height. But if my row is anything greater or equal to height, it will never actually pass that test and won't do anything. So I have to make sure that my row is less than height plus start row, and then my row goes up by one each time, making sure it always keeps within bounds on that height section. The same approach happens on the columns as well. Call starts off at start call. Call is less than width plus start call, so make sure I fit within the bounds that I'm working on, and then call goes up by one as well. Because I'm just doing a random value, I assign math.random times 256 to red, green, and blue, create a color based on those things, and assign that new pixel that value that we're working with. And so I randomize and get, aka, a little random, noise screen section to that rectangular specification that I specified with my start row, start call, width, and height. And if for some bizarre reason I have invalid numbers, I randomly reassign values to it. And explicitly, that random value shouldn't we do it all the time? I'm doing this though as a demonstration. You can change the parameter to make sure it fits within bounds if for some bizarre reason you get an out of bounds value for some reason. And that's what we're doing for this. We have the bounds checking on the width and height. Then we have the bounds checking our starting and call and row position. And then based on the starting row positions, we make sure we do the test against the height plus the start row and width plus the start call, making sure we check the bounds appropriately so we go over the appropriate amount of stuff. Thanks again. Have a great day. Cheers. We'll see you next time.